Hi guys, I'm Roslyn.
Hi guys, I'm Fenella.
Welcome to our YouTube channel, Roslyn and Fenella.
Our first video is going to consist of ways to tackle insecurities. We thought that we'd just go straight into the video instead of like doing an
intro.
Yeah, because no one knows us anyway. So if we do get big, by God's grace, then we'll do like a question and answer.
Yeah. So like we're just going to bun the intro and just like go straight into it. So, cool. So like we wrote like points on how to tackle insecurities. So the first thing that we said was watch what you say to people because you don't know what they're going through. You could say something
to trigger someone
most definitely. Insecurity, and even then sometimes people might not have an insecurity. Like for example, I don't know, someone can be like to me, you only have one dimple that's deep and the other one is so faint.
And then you start dwelling on it
I'll go home and I'll be like, wait,
I only have one dimple.
Even though that was a crap example, but like it could then become an insecurity. So we definitely feel like you should watch what you say to people because it could trigger someone to have an insecurity, or someone might already have an insecurity and then because people keep talking about it, they'll now go home
more insecure
and they'll start like crying because you never know, like especially in secondary.
It's true. It's a thing where if you see that someone already has an insecurity, why would you now go and talk about it as well? It's like you want to put the person down. That's what I don't get. And it just annoys me like to see people and they'll be like, oh yeah, for example, I don't know, what are some insecurities people have? There's a lot of things.
Big nose,
for example, and then everyone, and you generally know that the person gets hurt, but you still keep saying, look at you with your big nose or fat nose. Like, it's just no need.
Well,
you may laugh, sometimes it's banter.
I was just about to say that.
Even as banter, you don't know. So don't.
Because that's why I say, especially in secondary school, because in secondary school, the corn was different. Like, people get grilled on a different level.
Most definitely.
But it's like, people could laugh about it, but then you never know, like, what when they go home, they might start crying and then. Like, you don't know what happened to the person, and then it'll be all your fault.
More like that. What's the second point? This one. Don't compare yourself to other people. Please, please, and please. Please, please, and please. Don't compare.
That's like the worst thing you could do in my life.
Listen. We're all created differently. Why would you want to be like someone else? Or why are you going to compare and be like, oh, you know what? She has a big bum. Or for boys, you know what? Oh, you know what? He's so hench. I need to go to gym. I need to ban gym. If you want to actually change yourself,
if you
want to
do it for yourself.
But don't be like, no, that guy's hench. He's getting bad girls. Let me. Why? Why would you want to do that to yourself? You get it?
Definitely.
You need to know your intention as well. If you're comparing, be like, oh, no, you know what? I aspire to be like that, you know? In terms of, you know, for your own, do you get it? For your own well-being and you feel like you'll be happy, then that's perfectly
but
fine.
If you're doing it, like for example, say you're a girl and then you you see like another girl's getting attention and it's because of how she dresses or how her body is, and then you're now there wanting to basically copy
because
her
you want that
because you want male attention. It's not every day.
We're getting to that point.
Hold my mouth.
We're getting to that because there's many points, don't listen to other people's opinion, please. You expand, please.
Because listen, everyone's gonna have an.
Jesus. Now, guys, you know what? We're putting all this in because we're starting.
Why can't we talk? Why are we fighting the English?
The English is really doing. Cool.
Everyone is gonna have an opinion of you, no matter what you look like. Like,
as well,
even people that may not even be insecure, they could even be insecure, but we look at them as in they're like the perfect person. Like, I know for some, someone like Cassie, like she's so, or Rihanna even, because everyone loves Rihanna. Like, she's so pretty and whatever, but people still have opinions of her. Like, people may still say, oh, Rihanna's ugly, or Rihanna's skinny, or Rihanna's blah, blah, blah. But at the end of the day, like, if you love yourself, then other people's opinions will not matter. Because if someone came to me now and said, oh, no, you're clumped, I'll be like, okay, each to their own. And the thing is, you know what I hate about this generation as well, or society, whatever you want to say, is like, if a girl thinks she's pretty and she voices it,
she's on a high horse.
You think you're prestige, fam? Oh, blah 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 blah.
Do things. Listen, no. Come closer, come. Do things for yourself, not to impress man them.
Not for the man them. And you boys as well, not for girls as well. It's not every day of a gender.
Listen to me. Listen now, yeah?
I swear, my life, this pisses me off.
Listen, yeah? It's not every day. Oh, you know what? No. If I had a big bum, you know Michael would move to me, you know? Okay. But is Michael the only boy in the world?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have to have a big bum to be moved to?
Mm-hmm.
How is it?
And girls, yeah, please, you need to remember this, yeah? Boys will be screaming, oh, yeah, I want a fit girl, big fat, big tits. These times, they'll probably end up covering a girl that's slim anyway. That's just their preference.
Girls is also like,
it doesn't mean they're never going to go for a slim girl.
Slim, skinny girls, whatever term you want to call it as well. Stop. It actually pains me that they actually feel like, you know what, I actually need to become thick in order to become a standard of beauty. Do you know how?
Yeah.
That is, I don't even know how to explain it. Do you get it?
It's not everyday mandem validation.
And
like,
the thing is, why do you, okay, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. If you actually want that with you, that's fine, that's up to you, innit?
But it's a thing where if like you're doing it for mandem,
yeah,
then that's just a no.
Or you're doing it to fit a standard of beauty. Who's the one that says what beauty is and what it isn't?
Mm-hmm.
Who is it? Let me know, that's what I'm trying to say.
It proper hurts my heart, I can't lie, like when I see girls that are slim, and slim girls, their body's so nice.
They're nice.
But then they're like, oh, nah, I need to be thick because thick girls get attention, blah, blah, blah. Or
it's even a thing where they're just tired of the experience of being skinny because of what other people have labelled them to be.
That's why we say, don't focus on other people's opinions.
And I know it can get tiring because, listen guys, that's why we're actually doing this channel. Okay, sometimes, yeah. Let's not deny it. Everyone's gonna call someone. It's not their cup of tea, or they're not very appealing. Yeah. So
definitely.
with that now, it's kind of thing where sometimes it's not all the time that you must comment on it.
Yeah.
I feel like as well.
That's why our first point was actually be careful with what you say to people, because okay,
you, don't know how
you may not like something on someone, but someone else will.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just like even other people as well. Like if you're insecure as well, or people keep saying stuff to you. That's because they don't like it.
Yeah, as well.
Do you get what I mean? They're the ones that don't like it, but there is going to be someone that does like it.
Mm-hmm.
Because
too many people in this
you're
world.
Not going to be everyone's cup of tea.
This is a good one. Just because something is different, don't see it as an insecurity.
Yeah.
As well. Mm-hmm. And for example, especially if we're going into, I don't know if this is the point, but I'll just touch on it briefly. And for example, like, there's kind of a gender role when it comes to how a boy or girl should be sculpted as well. Concerning looks. For example, I'm a tall girl, and then they'll be like, you're tall.
Yeah,
or,
it's like,
or
even if a boy is short, it's
like,
hey,
sis,
6 foot only.
Hey, sis. But
yeah.
If he's a tall girl, yeah, she's mandem.
She's mandem.
Or if a girl has big feet, what's going on, she's a clown.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like that.
You see what I mean?
Like,
people need to stop stuff like that as well, because that's what makes people become insecure.
Exactly. And the thing is, Who said tallness was only for boys? Who said shortness was only for girls? Come on, as well, can you deep it as well?
You have to actually deep it. Not every boy in this life is going to be 6 foot plus.
Not every girl is
going to be 5'3" and below.
Can I help it that my dad was tall? Can I help it? Look, and sadly, can I help it? Come on, be real now. Be realistic as well.
You actually have to think
and
about it.
And it's one of them ones where what I hate is the fact that people put it on you, as in, yes, it is an insecurity. No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Do you get where I'm coming from?
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Oh, yeah, but you're tall, though.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know where you're trying to come with here. I remember one time someone was like to me, what did they even say? They was like, oh, yeah. You wish you were short, innit? Nah, I don't still. Because I love myself. Yeah. They actually said that. It's like, oh, you wish. Now, sometimes you wish you were short, innit? And I was like, nah, because I love my height and I embrace my height. But I don't want to be short. Now that I've overcome it, I don't care what anyone says. But it's like, it's the stupid remarks
it's
that just get me
jarring.
Upset. Because if I was in the place that I was back then,
You don't even know what you would have done.
I would have cried. Because before, I used to cry over everything. I literally, that was how I am.
Mm.
At my age, at 15, 16, I used to cry. That's just how I was. And you couldn't tell me anything because that's how I feel. Mm-hmm. You can't tell people how to
definitely.
Feel.
Definitely.
That's what I'm saying. So people need to be careful.
With what they say.
Most definitely.
I really feel like that's the most important thing. It's other people. That's what makes people become insecure. Mm-hmm. Like, guys, me and Roz are our besties. I'm sure everyone already knows this. But it's like, even when I'm with her, I hear the remarks, like the sly remarks that people will say.
Mm.
And it pisses me off. And it's not even me.
Mm.
Because it's literally an everyday thing. Like, if you know Roz and you know that she's tall and you know that she's slim, people will say stupid stuff like, oh, you need to eat more.
Mm.
Baby girl, baby boy, she eats a lot.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing as well.
It's
the misconception.
Hella jarring.
The misconception.
They always.
And it's more.
Do you know
that
amount of time
yeah.
I've heard people say that to you? Like, it's so annoying. And if you know Roslyn, you know this girl.
Don't eat.
Be like, yeah, don't eat. You need to get some meat on your girl. You don't eat a lot. I'm just like,
okay.
This girl eats so much. If you know Roslyn, you know that she eats so much.
Like, slim girls actually eat more than anyone else.
Yeah, they
or
do.
Skinny girls or whatever.
They really do.
They really do. Like, you think Fenella's the one that eats more than me, when it's actually the other way around. It's not even forcing it, it's just been like that.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. The next point that we wrote was to be around people that uplift you.
Most definitely.
So,
most definitely.
Obviously, if you're around negative people and say they're always pinpointing your insecurities, and of course, when you have your friends, you'll tell them what you don't really feel comfortable about concerning your face or your body, whatever. And that's like me saying, oh, look at you, your flat bum.
Yeah.
And it's just like, okay, but you knew though.
Heartbreak.
Wonderful. But it's just like, you knew though.
Mm.
So like, on my life, if you have friends like that.
You're more than your body.
Mm-hmm.
You're more than your looks.
Mm-hmm.
You have much more to help. But we're not here on this life to be doing that comparing. It's like, oh yeah, you know what? You have a nice nose, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you know what? Get gold sticker for having nice lips.
Mm-hmm.
No one cares. Literally.
It's true.
The people that point it out, they're probably insecure themselves, or they just have nothing better to do in life. Guys, seriously, they probably just have nothing better to do in life. You know, there's some people so judgmental, always cussing people.
But majority of the time, people who pinpoint like things that are wrong with other people or people who are bullies are usually insecure with themselves. And that's the reason why they get onto other people to make themselves feel better.
Most definitely.
So that's why, like we said already, you don't let other people's opinions get to you, because at the end of the day, you are who you are and you're actually not going to change. So you need to just accept the way you are. Everyone is all beautiful. This heart is flopping.
This beautiful point. This beautiful. Yeah, you need to get close.
Guys and girls. This really goes out to girls though, I can't lie to you. Don't look for security from the other gender.
Why is that, Vanilla?
I'm going to repeat that point one more time. Don't look for security from the other gender. Don't do this temporary love.
It's, listen to the key term. Listen to the key term. Note it down.
Temporary.
Yeah.
Love.
Temporary.
Not permanent.
Short term.
Temporary.
Short term.
Don't do it, girls. Guys, I don't know if you do it, but I know that girls do it a lot. So this is mainly going to go out to the girls.
They look, they devalue themselves so much. They'll get into relationships where it's not even healthy for them. But because they have that security of love for that temporary moment in time, the boy's not even treating them right.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, they still go to the guy. Why?
And you let all this stupid stuff run. He'll be taking you for dickhead. You're running to your friends for advice.
And
you
don't
even take
the
advice. You go back to the stupid boy that's treating you like a dickhead.
You don't even listen.
And who's looking like a dickhead? You. Not the boy. You, not the boy.
Dickhead.
Freak. Dickhead.
Idiot.
Foolish. Non-entity.
You stupid, I love it.
Definitely. Look at your life.
Okay, cool.
Listen to me, please. God. I don't think you don't understand how much I'm begging, because you know when you do that, it's only going to make you more insecure, and then you're going to have to keep relying on the other gender to like English. you're gonna keep going to.
Wow! Oh my god!
You're stretching it. You're gonna keep going to the other gender to feel some type of security, when that's not what you should be doing. You should be secure within yourself.
That's right.
Baby girl.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And another point, don't get into a relationship until you love yourself. because if you do that, you will never love yourself. You will rely on the man to love you, and this time the man doesn't even love you. Please love yourself before you get into a relationship. Please. Because I've actually had enough of girls doing this now. It gets me very angry. There's some guys as well that will look for insecure girls so they can feel
empowered.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Like maybe they're even insecure themselves because you think they will ever go for a girl that's like, I don't know, that loves themselves. Because really and truly, yeah, if I got into a relationship, yeah, and a man was treating me like one freak, lock off, the relationship will be done. Like, I fully don't care. But if you're an insecure girl, like I said, you let things run, like you will not leave the man.
See your
basically
work, you just feel like, yeah, but I'm in the relationship.
Mm-hmm. Right. And the relationship will end is because he ended it with you. Mm-hmm. You will never end it with him, exactly. And then he'll go look for another insecure girl. Mm-hmm. I've actually seen that happen bare times.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is,
we gonna sip that tea.
Mm-hmm. And you lot are piping and you're thinking it's a good relationship. No, it's just,
it's
like,
not.
Anyway, thing where, you know what? Okay, you look at yourself. Yeah, you know what? It's life. Like, if anything, you can change it later on in the future if you wish to do so.
Yeah, if you're like proper unhappy.
But literally, guys, you need to deep it. It's just looks. Just looks.
And like I said, you're not everyone's cup of tea. Someone will like you the way you are.
And you need to deep it just because you haven't found someone in your specific area, in your specific uni, college, secondary, whatever, workplace.
There's actually too many people. Also, pause, it's not every day they are busy.
Sex anyway, sometimes for yourself, sometimes just love you for you.
You have to deep it.
This one is a bit as well. Indirect comments and not acknowledging that other person. So what we mean by this is, cool, okay, let's say there's me and Finella. And every time someone's coming and be like, oh, you know what, Roslyn? Your hair's nice. Next day, oh no, Roslyn, you're top, you know. Finella's just there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, Roslyn, you look pink today, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Again, what crap are those?
I keep
the thing is, yeah, we're not saying forced comments, compliments, sorry, but it's even simple things like, oh, you know what, Finella, your top is nice as well.
Mm.
Sometimes you don't know how insecure someone is.
Yeah.
You might be like, okay, but why is Finella might be thinking, oh, why do you always compliment Roslyn though? Do I not look good?
Mm-hmm.
You don't know the level of someone's insecurity.
Yeah.
I've seen this.
Yeah, I've seen it.
I've seen girls like this, and
I've
just
seen
voiced it.
Yeah.
To us as well.
Definitely have voiced it to us.
So then it's
that's
like,
why
okay,
we
cool.
Had
it's
to
not by force,
this.
But it's a kind of thing where it's just to appreciate someone for something as
yeah.
Well. Like, oh, you know, I like your jeans.
Yeah.
You
never
you
know.
Never
you
know
even
that
just
makes
saying,
your day.
Oh,
they might
your jeans
make their
look
day.
Nice. Exactly. It might make them really happy.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's because also as well, yeah. You have to actually really deep it, because imagine if that was you now, and you keep going to the same girl, and you're complimenting her every day. And then
there.
The friend is just standing there, like you've never said anything to her. All it is a simple hi, and that's
well,
it.
Some, you know, some people. Yeah.
Sometimes they even exactly. Sometimes people don't
not
even
saying,
say
it's
hi.
It's not by force, but guys, like it's just little gestures. Sometimes, like, sometimes just think beyond yourself. It's not all about you as well.
But then that also. Goes into our next point for the girls that are insecure is just because your friend is getting attention, don't compare yourself
as
to
well,
your friend
as well.
Because maybe your friend just got her hair done, the makeup was on fleek that
maybe
day,
just always popping.
The outfit
you know,
was just
yeah.
Maybe you just weren't doing bits that day, maybe you know, I know uni, sometimes you can't be asking it. Maybe you're just wearing, I don't know, leggings and simple top or something like that. Mm. Say people are always complimenting your friend. Maybe she's looking A1 every day, like Roslyn said.
Mm.
Just because people are always complimenting her doesn't mean you need to now go and compare yourself
and the things,
to and that friend.
Exactly, and it doesn't devalue you as a person.
It doesn't.
Like, literally.
It really doesn't.
It really doesn't devalue you.
And if you see that as well, like, I don't know, try change something. Like, maybe do something different with your hair.
Mm.
Or I don't know, change the way you dress or something. I don't know, like maybe you just look.
And if you're doing it, but if you're doing it, if that's how you're comfortable, then you're comfortable. Do you get it?
Exactly. But if you're, because you know some people they just want compliments. I don't know.
Do you know what I mean? The thing is though, you need to be yourself in order to gain compliments. Yeah. Listen, guys. Yeah. For example, because
definitely,
like I don't wear makeup. Yeah, I still get compliments. So how do you explain that? Do you get it? It's not, I don't look
it's
for
true.
It, I'm myself, and then
people
see my personality and people see me for me. I don't always do colour in my hair like Fenella or something. Like, I'm actually a very simple girl. I don't like to really experiment or whatever.
It's
but
true.
I would experiment if I think it will bang on me or something. But I'm not gonna go out of my way for
and
compliment.
Do it.
I'm me for me. I like to be simple. I am simple. Do you get it? I'm not gonna force it. No one can ever force me to do something I don't wanna do. That's simply it. Why am I doing it for other people?
Of course.
Who cares? But it's kind of thing where, oh, how can you change your perspective on someone else? That's how I view it as well.
Definitely.
I wanna be the one that helps people and, you know, get them out of a place that they're in. You don't want people to be, you know?
Definitely.
That's it.
I agree.
I don't feel like that's the way. Don't be a hypocrite.
Hey, this one now. Yeah, we actually have to come close for this one. Don't be a hypocrite, okay? And get onto people for things that are seen as an insecurity.
Mm-hmm.
When you may even have something yourself that could be seen as an insecurity.
Look at the life you're living.
Because you will now go to someone and be like, you're bare tall. You're hella tall. And these times, say you have something.
Let's say it's a short boy.
Yeah, cool. We'll say it's a short boy. So say you're now going to the girl, oh, you're hella tall. But let's say he's like, 5'7". Let's say 5'7", because you know girls nowadays are 6 foot only. So say now, a girl now goes to him, oh, you're too short. He won't be able to take it. He'll be like, what do you mean I'm too short?
When you're tall.
Blah, blah, blah. It's like, don't get onto someone, and then when they flip it now, you can't take the heat.
Mm.
Don't be a hypocrite.
Mm.
Don't be a hypocrite.
Don't, seriously.
Like, I swear that actually gets me so mad.
Someone will have a big bum and then you're getting onto their breast. It's like, okay, yeah, but I don't have breasts. It's like, yeah, but I've got a bum though, okay? But
exactly.
Okay, well, it's not competition.
It's not competition.
No,
it's stupid.
Like,
can you imagine?
Yeah, yeah, but I get mad though, okay?
Okay. It's not everyday validation from man.
Yeah, exactly. Auntie, what's going on? Honest to God.
No, on my life. And there's actually some girls like that as well. That was the point I was gonna say. I was gonna say, relating to the just because your friend is getting attention, don't compare.
Yeah.
That's why I was gonna say that's why it relates to having friends that uplift you.
Because
if anything, as well, as a friend, naturally you should compliment your friend.
Mm-hmm. Most definitely.
Because naturally, guys, don't even lie, when you make friends with someone, you become their friend because you think that they're nice looking.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I wouldn't really, the way they look basically matches the way that you look. So that's what I say, really and truly, when you choose your friends, you choose them based on
how
alike
you
are as a person. So naturally, obviously, you're going to find your friend pretty or whatever. So you, as a friend too, compliment your friend. Say, oh, you look nice today. Oh, I like your hair. Like, you don't have to do it every day, but like here and there, just compliment them a bit because you never know, obviously make them feel better.
Don't let preference get you down. Jesus
Christ.
Some people prefer black girls. Some people prefer black boys. Some people prefer white girls. Some people prefer white boys.
Some people prefer Asian. Some people prefer whatever as they is.
Okay, if you're talking image, some people prefer thick. Some people actually prefer thin. Thin.
Slim.
Some people prefer slim.
It's okay.
It doesn't matter. It's about love. It's not always about image as well. It's about your connection with the person.
Obviously, appearance is what attracts the person and whatever.
Most definitely.
But then
it's not by force though.
Exactly.
Someone will find you attractive and you will.
That's why I always say people could say their preference is fake, whatever. But they could end up
a slim girl.
Exactly.
Because they vibe with the slim girl.
Do you know how many rappers even beat in their songs talking about?
How many times has Chris Brown talked about thick and he's always cuffing Karrueche's? How many Karrueche's exactly?
Karrueche slim, like that's what I'm saying. People say stuff and whatever, but they might not actually go for what their actual preference is. Because at the end of the day, it's a preference. It's not like they're saying I will only go for that.
They just like the look of it as well, which is because it is
exactly.
It's a nice body shape, but who says slim isn't nice?
Isn't nice either. But yeah, just to like round up this video.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't let people's opinions get to you. Like, there's how many people on this earth?
Too many.
Like, just because somebody doesn't find you attractive, it doesn't mean that you're not attractive at all. There is somebody that will find you attractive. You could be insecure right now. Hopefully you get over that insecurity. At the end of the day, the way you look right now, you are still gonna get wifed. Mm-hmm. You are still gonna have husband, you're still gonna have children. Mm-hmm. If it's a mandem approval thing that is basically like mm-hmm. the reason for your insecurity.
Mandem, you're still gonna get it. Mandem, you're still, listen, you're the ones that pursue the girl, if anything. So you just,
if anything,
pursue,
yeah.
Like, do you get it? Like, it's calm. Like, guys, just like on the last tip, like, God created you so beautifully. I don't think you understand. And it's one of them ones where you have to find your source of love. And what I mean by that is, if you're, as you said in the points, if your source of love is in man, then you will seek love within that. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You'll only find love there, if that makes sense. And that's why it's all temporary and you're all getting, you
know, you always get damaged. That's where it goes wrong. Girls get so damaged because of that.
If you seek love in, for example, sex, yeah, you're always gonna find yourself in that place, but you never feel happy within yourself.
Mm-hmm.
What I would advise is to seek your love in God. Why? Because God's love is eternal. Why? Because God made you. He knows who you are. He didn't make you to be insecure, my guy. My girl, He didn't make you to be insecure. Seriously, your love, where your love lies, is how, you know, you're gonna approach everyday life. And I just feel like it saddens me when boys and girls are insecure.
It's like, it feels to the point where it's like, nah, like, my legs are too big. I absolutely hate them. Like, I need to get them reduced. Mm. Or, I don't know, like,
I feel so low. Some people literally, they're just lying.
Yeah.
Some people are depressed about it, you know.
Big man too.
Some people are depressed about how they look.
Big man thing, but like, really, it's just, you should not be depressed about it. Like, just learn to love yourself, honestly.
But
also,
yeah,
guys, you know, like, if you ever want to talk to us, we're gonna put the socials, you know what I mean, DM us, tweet us, whatever, and we're good to go.
But that's the end of the video, guys. But make sure you tune in for our next one. Put the notification bell on, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to Rosanna Vanilla.